Good morning everyone from Genoa and welcome on the Flight Sim Passion channel. Note that this tutorial works for all the 737 variants available in Microsoft Flight Simulator, but I'm not a real pilot and this tutorial is just a quick overview on how to perform the various flows and checklists to get this beauty started up. There are really detailed tutorials by real pilots on this aircraft. In case, I suggest you to check these channels out. Alright, let's not waste your time and get inside the aircraft. Okay, as you can see, the airplane is already started up, but let's imagine that it is the first flight of the day for this airplane. So let's put the cold and dark state into the FMC by going to PMDG setup, state load, and then cold and dark executed, loading panel state. And as you can see, everything is now turned off. Okay, from this state, the first thing that we'll do is turn on the battery, arm the emergency XE lights over here, and then go back to the FMC, go into FS Actions, Ground Services, and request the ground power in order to get electrical power available for the aircraft. As you can see, once it's connected, it will turn on like this, and then we'll turn on the ground power by pushing this switch right here. Okay, we now have electrical power for the aircraft. Let's now do the first checks. So, let's go onto this panel, which is over the overhead panel. First of all, let's align the IRSs, which are basically GPSs, which calculate our position on the Earth. If you'd like to see the status of their alignment, you can go onto the heading status option into the IRS display and check the number right here, which indicates the minutes left for the full alignment. In this case, I've got 0 minutes because my IRS option is set to instant. Then let's get onto the flight recorder on the right. Let's test it by doing this. You can see that the light went off, so the flight recorder works normally. Let's test the airspeed warnings. So number one, good. Number two, checked. We'll wait for the stall warning test since they need around 5 minutes to turn on completely. In the meanwhile, let's go onto the left here on the flaps panel. Let's test it out by pressing this button. You can see all the lights illuminating, which means that the panel works correctly. And now let's get back onto the overhead panel. We'll divide the panel in blocks. We'll start from the left one by turning the yaw damper on and turning the fuel pump aft one on. We've got nothing to check here for now. Let's get onto the center panel where you can manage your panel brightness here, but we don't need it for now since it's daytime. Then let's turn on the chimes and let's set the fasten seatbelt signs to auto. You can do this depending on your preference or the airline you're flying for. On the adjacent panel, let's turn on the window heat on the left and the right side. You can see the green lights coming on. We won't use any anti-ice for today since it's hot outside, but instead we'll turn the hydraulic pumps on. Don't worry about the forward entry light over here, which means that the front left door here is open. Then let's get onto the last block and go all the way up to the voice recorder. Let's put it to on. It will set itself automatically to auto once the engines are started. Let's put the air temperature to forward. In case you're flying the 700 variant or the 600 variant, you'll have to turn the knob to pass cabin. Then let's go all the way down to the pressurization panel and let's set on the upper needle our cruise level, which is going to be flight level 390 for today. And below it, let's set our landing altitude. In this case, our destination airport, Palermo, has a elevation of 33 feet, which is closer to 50 feet than zero. So let's set 50 feet right here. Then let's get onto the pedestal. Make sure that the transponder is set to standby and that your squawk code is set. In this case, today's squawk will be 4336. Let's check our oxygen masks. Let's press this button to test them. All right, it works correctly. Let's get to the first officer's side and check it too. So let's press this button again. All right, the oxygen masks all work. Let's get down here and let's turn on the test lights. As you can see, all the lights in the cockpit are now illuminated. You can check all of them. So the overhead panel looks fine too. This panel looks fine. The pedestal looks good too, and every light on the engine fire panel is illuminated. So let's get it back to bright. If you'd like to dim them out, you can do that by pressing down here. Then let's arm the auto brake into the rejected takeoff position. Let's go for the engine fire tests. So let's check the engine fault, then the engine fire. We've got all the lights illuminated correctly. Then let's check if these lights come on. If I put the switch to 1 and to 2. Perfect. So the tests are now completed. We can now start the APU. So let's do it by pushing the knob to start. And you'll initially see the low oil pressure light coming on and the EGT indication going up. Low oil pressure now goes off. And now we'll wait for the generators to be available. Okay, there we go. APU generators are now available. Let's turn them on. By doing that, the electrical power is now supplied by the APU instead of the ground power. So we can now disconnect it from the FMC. So let's release it. And now let's quickly set up our FMC. Okay, first of all, let's go onto the menu, press on FMC. Let's check that all the information here are correct. Then pause in it. And here we'll set our coordinates calculated by the IRSs. Don't use this one. Instead, use the GPS left one, as it should be more accurate. So let's put it in. And as you can see, the screens now follow the indications from the IRSs. Let's go onto the root page and let's put our flight plan in. So I'm simulating a real-world flight, which happened not too long ago from Genoa to Palermo. So our origin will be Lima, India, Mike, Juliet, which is the ICAO code for our origin airport. ICAO code for our destination Palermo is Lima, India, Charlie, Juliet. Note that I'm gonna put all the information manually instead of uplinking the flight plan into the FMC. If you'd like to check out a tutorial on how to set up the FMC while uplinking the route, then I'd suggest you to check this video out. Our flight number today is going to be Ryanair 5 for Lima Juliet. Since we're flying offline, we'll already put our runway in, so it's going to be runway 28. Let's go onto the next page, and right here we'll put all the waypoints of our route. So our first waypoint will be UNITA. After that, we'll go to Connor via the Lima 50 airway. So let's put Connor on the right side. Then we'll go direct to Kisto. Then direct to Ronap. And our last waypoint for our route will be Jano. Let's activate it and we'll execute everything after checking that all the information is correct. Now let's go onto our departure arrival page. Let's go onto Lima, India, Mike, Juliet, departure. Let's set runway to 8. And we'll fly to our first point, UNITA, via the UNITA 6 Echo departure today. Meanwhile, our arrival will be the Jano 3 November. And our approach will be the Arnav Zulu for runway 07 in Palermo via the XOC transition. So let's get onto our legs page now. Let's check if everything is correct by going on to the plan mode over here. As you can see, the route here is blue to indicate that it's not executed yet. Let's check this out. If you press step, you'll go one waypoint ahead. So this is our SID. And then we'll continue our route. Let's check. We got Kisto, then Ronap. And after that, we got Jano. After Jano, we've got the right standard arrival, as you can see, which is composed of all these little waypoints right here. So everything is checked. We can execute the route. So let's press execute. And everything, as you can see, is now connected by a magenta line. All right, let's quickly load the aircraft. You've got two ways to do this. The first one, which is not gonna be covered in this video, is through the ground services. And the second option, which is less realistic, obviously, but easier to get used to, it's by going into the fuel and payload page right here. So let's go onto fuel. Our block fuel today is going to be 7,319 kilos. Return let's go onto the payload page, and our estimated zero fuel weight is going to be 58.377 tons, and let's click here near the zero fuel weight indication. All right, now the airplane is fully loaded. Let's go onto the init ref page. Here we have the performance init page. Let's click two times on the zero fuel weight to get the correct zero fuel weight from the aircraft. Let's put our reserves, which are indicated on the flight plan, and they are 3,144 kilos. So let's round it up to 3.2. Remember to always round this up. Cost index today is going to be 15, and our cruise level, as we said before, is going to be flight level 390. Our cruise wind will be 013 at 26 knots. And our ISA at the top of climb is going to be plus 1, so minus 56 plus 1 is minus 55. Transition altitude in Genoa is 7,000 feet. Let's put 7,001 in case we get a clearance to 7,000 feet. Let's check that all the information is correct and execute it. Now, let's go onto the N1 limit page. We'll put a 22k derated takeoff and a climb 1 profile in order not to use the max power out of the engines. Then let's go onto the takeoff page. Today we'll go for a flaps 5 takeoff. Let's click two times on the central gravity here to get the correct central gravity on the airplane. And now, as you can see, we've got some calculated V speeds. So let's put them in. We've got V1 140, VR 140, and V2 146. If you'd like to have more precise V speeds, you can go onto the next page here and set all the data right here. Okay, last but not least, let's set up our altimeters. So by looking at the weather in Genoa, we've got QNH 1015, so let's set this needle to hectopascals, since Italy uses hectopascals as a standard unit instead of inches of mercury. So let's set 1015. Let's check that it's set on the left, on the right side, and also on the standby altimeter. Let's now turn on the flight directors on the left and the right side. If you're flying on the captain's side, remember to turn it on first on the captain's side so that it has the master light on. Then let's arm the autofrost and put our V2 speed, which is 147, correction, 146. Let's set our runway heading, which is going to be 280. And our initial altitude will be 7,000 feet for now. Let's arm VNAV and LNAV. We can remove our stairs and close the doors. And we can also remove the wheel shocks. But before doing that, remember to pull the parking brakes. And to do that, you must press on the brakes first and then click here. All right, the parking brakes are set. And now let's remove the wheel shocks. And before starting the engines, let's first turn on all the fuel pumps and turn the anti-collision lights to advise the crew on the ground that we are ready for push and start. Today, we'll use the pushback function into the FMC. In this case, I'm using meters as units, but you can also use feet if you prefer. And by looking at our position, let's go for around 150 meters. Let's push this button here and go for a standard left push. We'll turn the nose right by about 60 degrees. Let's select the tug and start our pushback. Okay, let's set the parking brakes off. Brakes released. All right, as you can see, we started moving. So before starting the engines, let's make sure that the packs are off, that the APU bleed is on. And then we can initiate the engine start sequence by putting the engine start switch to ground. All right, starting engine 2. We've got N2 rising right here. Let's wait for around 20 to 25%, and then we'll put fuel in the engine. Right, 20, 22. All right, let's go for the fuel cutoff 2 to idle. As you can see, we've got fuel flow, we've got EGT rising, we've got N1 rising. And then we'll wait for it to stabilize itself and put the engine start switch back to off. All right, there we go. Now let's start engine 1 in the same way. So engine start switch 1 to ground. We've got N2 rising. All right, fuel cutoff 1 to idle. Pushback complete. Parking brake, please. Okay, pushband complete. Let's set the parking brakes. In the meanwhile, we've got fuel flow, EGT rising, N1 rising. Right, let's wait for the same thing on the number one. There we go. We can confirm a good engine start now, so let's go for the after start checklist. So, engines are switches, continuous. We can now use the electrical power from the engines, so generators 1 and 2 on. We can turn the APU off and turn the APU bleed off. Then let's set to auto both the packs and the isolation valve. After that, let's turn on the probe heat. As you can see, the voice recorder has automatically gone to auto after engine start. Let's now go for flaps 5. You can see the flaps extending on this indicator right here. So we got flaps 5 green light. Let's trim the aircraft real quick. So we've got 5.11 units. Let's set it up. Around here should be fine. And let's go for the flight controls check. So let's press this system button over here to get this page on this screen. And let's move our surfaces. So let's go for the ailerons. Pull left. Pull right. Neutral. Pull up. Pull down. Neutral. Rudder. Pull left. Pull right. Neutral. The flight controls are checked. We can clear this page up. Let's put our transponder to alt off. Let's start the clock on the right side. And in case you're fully ready for taxi and got a taxi clearance, we can put the taxi lights on and start moving. Alright everyone, part 1 comes to an end. I hope this tutorial has been helpful, and if you've got any feedbacks, don't hesitate to tell me about them in the comment section below. Thank you all so much for the 2400 subs everyone, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.